guys, it's Alyssa, and today I am getting my lip injections and I'm gonna bring you guys along because I'm super open about all that stuff. Everyone's asking me why I'm getting them done. So I'm getting them done because I've always been really insecure about my lips. I don't have an upper lip, and when I smile, they disappear. So I wanna get a little oomph to my lips, and yeah. So I had the worst cramps last night and I didn't know why, and I just got the notification from Spot On that I'm gonna get my period tomorrow. So, yay. So Spot On isn't just a period tracker, it also informs you on birth control, and it also gives you guidance how to meet with Planned Parenthood professionals and guidance counselors. And then it's free for download on iTunes and Google Play. So if you guys want to track your cycle like I do, it literally saves my life, and be informed on all those things that are so important to have, you should definitely click the link below and download Spot On and support Planned Parenthood. And then I also want to thank Spot On for sponsoring this video. And then as well, if you guys do enjoy this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up, and let's try and get this video to 700 likes. And if you're new here, hi, my name is Alyssa. Subscribe and turn on my post notifications. It would mean a lot. We're almost at 100K, which is insane. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Let's go get my lips done.
So after your consult last time, about a week or so ago, have you had any concerns whatsoever that have come up since then?
No, not really.
Okay.
I'm just really excited.
So am I. Yep. We've gone over your medical history, and you're a really good candidate for this, and your lips are a very good candidate for it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a mirror so that we can confirm what we're going to do. Okay. And so what I see is that your upper lip is just a little bit smaller than your lower lip, so you don't have the proper proportion and such. They're beautiful lips, so don't get me wrong on that, but it would be nice for your face to make them a bit more proportioned. They also don't have a lot of the pillowing or softness, rounded curves as well, and I think we can accentuate that without going overboard for you. But I will put a little bit more in the top than I will in the bottom. I still want some in the bottom just to keep it matched, but we'll work with the upper to make it a little bit more voluminous. We're going to start with just a small amount, perhaps a quarter to a half syringe, and we're going to take a look, and then we'll decide what we want to do. Do we want to go further or do we stop? So I'm going to have you go over consent, and it basically covers everything that we talked about. You're going to have a little bit of swelling for a couple of days. Some people will swell very, very little where it just looks great, put a little gloss on it and you're good to go. Some people have a bit more swelling where they feel a little self-conscious and they want to stay inside, but for most people it's ready to go.
Yeah.
You can get a bruise, not a high bruise area, but you just cover it with makeup or lipstick if that happens. It can be a little tender when you're eating, but that goes away. It's very tolerable. You don't need meds for that, for that whatsoever. The one thing that we have to make sure is that we're safe, so that I don't hit any arteries and make any issues with it. So I go slow, and so this is going to take a little bit of your time so that we're safe and that we get a good result. Okay, so that's all listed there in the consent, and if you have any issues with it, please talk to me.
All right, that's it.
Thank you very much. Okay. So now I'm going to put the freezing on. So it's going on as a cream. It's really yucky as it goes on. I don't know if you ever used baby Aura gel or anything like that. It's like this. So if it gets on your tongue, it'll feel a little numb. And I'm being very generous with this so that we have good freezing. If you need to spit or dab your tongue, you're welcome to use that. Okay? So we're going to let that sit for about 15-20 minutes so that you get a really good freezing and that we can make it as comfortable as possible.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So I'm just going to wipe off the excess right here. And what I'd like you to do is take this cold pack, and we'll start right up here. And we use, yes, just like that. And we use the ice, or I like to use the ice. One, it just makes it feel better. And two, sometimes it can reduce bruising. Some people say no, but it's not gonna hurt. Mm-hmm. So I think it's a good thing to be there. I'm gonna have you bring that down. I'm gonna wipe it right now. And this is just to clean it off. Now I'm gonna get started. Actually, I'm gonna come over here. Go nice and nice slow. So I go really slow. One, it helps with the comfort level, but two, it also helps to minimize issues down the road. Now, you may feel a bit of pressure. You may have felt a bit of a bite. You may have felt basically nothing at all. Filler has freezing in it as well, so it will be comfortable very shortly. Now put the cold right on there. How was that?
It was good. There's just like little prick, kind of like it was like, oh.
Okay.
It's good.
It's good. Okay. So the combination makes it quite tolerable. Yeah. So as I was saying, there are different fillers out there, and I choose different ones depending on what kind of filler lip change I need. I'm softening, so I'm using a bit of a finer filler, and sometimes I have to create structure with an older lip, so I would use something a little different in that case. Okay, bring that down please. You can take this out, which is the beautiful thing about hyaluronic acid fillers. We use an enzyme, and it can dissolve an area. Say I've got a little bumpy in this spot. Well, I can fix that with a little bit of the enzyme. Or for some reason, for some people, they just feel that they don't want it anymore. Mm-hmm. So I can use that to take it out. But it's nice to have an eraser, shall we say, to work with it. It makes it that much safer. The second side, often the left side, can feel a little bit more than the right side. And we have no idea why that is, but the cold on. Are you feeling that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Way more on that side.
Yeah, I could see your eyelids flashing. Mm-hmm. Not flashing, but fluttering a little bit more. Mm-hmm. But you managed through that.
Yeah. It wasn't that bad.
Good, good. Didn't bring tears to your eyes, so that's a good thing. So I'm also being careful to maintain the peaks of her lips, the Cupid's bow as well. And we are right now in a sensitive part of the lip in the middle, but she did fabulous. Good job, good job. And I want it a bit more central, so that's where I'm going. I'm gonna squeeze hard. I can feel a little bit of a poke. I'm trying to go slow for you. Now pinching to just for that main poke, just to help you out there. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna pinch, and you're gonna feel just a little bit of that poke. I hope not much though, but the nice thing is the freezing from the first bit that I put in will have taken over. And that's enough for that side. And I need a little cold right here, please. So, what do you think? Do you think you need more? Do you think, because it is going to come down just a little bit.
Yeah.
Besides that, do you think you want a little bit more volume?
Yeah, so this is half a syringe, right?
Yes.
About that?
Mm-hmm.
I think I want a little bit more.
A little bit more? Okay. Because I've already been here, you have a chance of having a bit more freezing than before, so hopefully this is a bit easier on you.
Thank you.
Do you want a bigger lower lip? Do you want a bit more poutier?
Yeah.
Bit poutier?
That's what I want. A little bit bigger of a lower lip.
Okay. All right.
So I think the top looks like fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So then we'll just, I'm going to focus on the middle of the, and then we'll take a look.
Okay.
Okay.
This is so exciting. I want to cry. I'm so excited. I think this is one of the best days of my life. Yes, I like that.
Good.
It's perfect.
Okay. So we'll let it settle down. We'll do a follow-up. And then we'll, at that time, you'll decide as well, is this perfect?
Yeah.
Okay, right now it is, but it's got to settle. And then you'll assess it, and then you'll decide again, is it more or less? And then you'll, since it's your first time having this done, you don't really know exactly how much you want.
Yeah.
So after this, you won't be playing around. You'll just be doing it once because you'll know.
Okay. Exactly.
All
okay.
Right. So aftercare is very simple. I don't want excessive exercise today. I don't, you know, keep the kissing down a little bit today. There are some people who will say don't put anything on the lip for about 24 hours. However, I find that the lips become so uncomfortably dry, you need some chapstick or something on it.
I'm so excited. Thank you so much. Okay, so it is a week after I got, if you guys hear things outside, there's like a main road right outside, so just ignore it. And I asked you guys on my Instagram before, babe, be quiet. Nolan's playing Fortnite. So I asked you guys on my Instagram story to send me questions about my lip injections. And if you're not following me on my Instagram, I ask you guys to ask me questions and video ideas all the time, so you should definitely go follow me. So the first question I get asked a lot is, why am I getting lip injections, or why I got them? So pretty much I had a very tiny top and bottom lip. I've always been kind of insecure about it, not to a point where I'm like, I need to change this, but to a point where I just wanted to change it, and it's something that like would make me happy about the way I look. Did it hurt? So no, they actually didn't hurt that bad. The first couple of injections, which were on my top lip, as you saw in the clip before, you could tell that it kind of like flinched a little bit and it hurt. So yeah, it hurt more on the left side than the right. And then the bottom lip, I didn't feel at all. And then when we went over it again, I didn't feel it at all because the injection that she put in has freezing in it. So when you go over the second time, you actually don't feel it at all. I have a really high pain tolerance, but if I had to rate the pain from 1 to 10, 10 being the worst, I would say about like a 5 on the top lip. And then for the bottom lip, it was literally like nothing. Like, I didn't feel it at all, so like a 0. Okay, do you like them now? So I really do like my lips now. They're not a huge difference. If you guys didn't know, I use 3/4 of a syringe. They are a normal lip size now. I'll show you guys a before and after right now. But I actually think I'm going to be adding more when I do my follow-up appointment. My lips were literally like paper thin before, and this is kind of just like the normal lip look. I just want, I think, a poutier bottom lip and just more full all around. Do they last forever, or how long do they last? So typically lip injections last about 6 to 9 months, and it also depends on your metabolism, as Tracy told me. So my metabolism is really fast, so it's gonna break down the injections a lot faster than someone with a lower metabolism would. But if you're not going to be like smoking or drinking out of a straw, or like if you don't use your mouth, then they're obviously going to last longer if you don't move your lips as much. But no, they don't last forever. They do go away. And if you end up not liking them, there's this injection that you can get, and it pretty much dissolves the lip injections, which is great if you decide you don't like the look of them. How much did it cost per syringe and all that? So it obviously varies with every single nurse, but Tracy charges $600, that's with tax included, for a full syringe. So you typically won't get a full syringe depending on your lip size the first time you go. Most people usually get a half a syringe depending on the look they want to achieve. So if you only get half a syringe, you only pay for half the syringe, which would be like $300. So everybody has been asking me who's doing my lips because a lot of people are interested in getting them themselves, if my experience went well. And I can tell you right now, my experience went amazing and I loved having Tracy as my nurse. Tracy did my lip injections. Her Instagram handle will be right here as well as all of her links below. So if you live in Calgary, Alberta, she's actually at all of the Evelyn Charles locations and she does lip injections and all these different types of things. She's super experienced. Also, make sure you guys go follow her and comment on one of her recent posts, like at Alyssa Brielle sent me, and I'll follow some of you guys. So people also asked if it bruised. I was going to do a day by day until they were healed, but I never got bruising on my lips, which a lot of people said, hey, you're gonna bruise. And when I watched a lot of YouTube videos, people did bruise, and I didn't at all. I'm not too sure why I didn't bruise, or it didn't, like, I don't know. The healing process was so good for me and I didn't have any bruises, no problems. Like, my lips looked great when I first got them done too. I just like walked around the mall and my lips looked fine. Do you think it's worth the money? I 100% think it was worth my money just because I'm so happy with my lips now and I feel so pretty with them done. It's not a huge difference, but if it makes you happy, I say it's 100% worth the money. So that is all for this video. If you guys did enjoy, definitely give it a big thumbs up. Let's get this video to 700 likes. If you guys do have any other questions about lip injections, feel free to comment them below or even ask Tracy on her Instagram. And if you're new here, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on my post notifications. I make new videos every single Saturday. I will see you guys next Saturday. Bye guys.